It's time for your daily dose of Outriders news and updates. Yes, I'm playing the full game, and you're probably wondering, how do I get access to the full game early like I did? Well, I have a guide for you whether or not you are on Xbox or PlayStation. Now, for PlayStation users, it seems like you're good to go because the countdown timer is suggesting the full game will be releasing ahead of schedule. So it looks like by the time this video could go live, you should be having access to the game according to the timer. Now, Xbox is a little different, so we're going to go over that. This applies for both Game Pass users and those that bought it through the Xbox store. Now, I also have information about the day one update as well, so a lot to go over. Hey everyone, what's happening? Open World Games here. Hope you're doing good, and let's dive straight into how you can obtain early access to the full game right now. So first of all, what you're going to want to do is, of course, boot up your Xbox console and then grab your phone, but make sure you're logged into your Xbox console under your main account and also have your phone right by you with the Wi-Fi on. Now what you do is you have the Xbox app on your phone, go to that, open it up, sign into your main account, and then search for Outriders. You will see Outriders, the full game, right there as a second drop-down option. Click on it. You will be then prompted to enable remote play or remote download, and then you will also be prompted on your Xbox to approve that. You are going to want to go through those steps, and then you will also be prompted to download to your Xbox. Now, once you have Outriders fully downloaded on your Xbox, go ahead and go to your Xbox settings and switch to the New Zealand option. So first of all, go to your settings, as you can see right here, scroll down, and then you're going to want to go under system, language and location, and then switch your location to New Zealand. But wait, make sure you restart your console and then access Outriders. You have full access to Outriders, the full game. Go for it. Now again, if you're on PlayStation, it seems like you're going to be covered here very, very soon, and you'll be able to start playing right now ahead of schedule. Now, press and review sites have access to the game, but I wanted to let you guys know, hey, it seems like you have access as well very, very soon. Now, also, we're going to be talking about that day one patch, but a lot of you are probably wondering, well, changing to my time zone to New Zealand on Xbox, does this count as cheating? Well, guess what? People Can Fly did respond about this. They are the developers, of course. They confirmed that it is not considered cheating according to them, so you are covered there. Do not worry about changing your time zone to New Zealand. Now, of course, once we get past launch day, you can flip it back to whatever time zone you are in and just continue playing, and you are good to go. So that is really, really good news. Now, I am having an absolute blast so far in the game, and I cannot wait to keep going. And I'm noticing captains are absolutely everywhere. Now, there was the day one update as well. We're going to talk about how you can actually adjust the camera shake. Now, the cinematic camera shake option here is going to be found under gameplay, and then you can go here and adjust it to make sure you limit that camera shaking in those cinematics, because a lot of us are super annoyed by that. Now, of course, there was a day one patch. It was about 16 gigabytes, and let's take a look at what that includes right now. So they go on to say this. This is a patch we're hoping to have ready and integrated into preloading even before launch, so it's already out. It says if everything goes according to plan, you won't have to download this on day one, but there is a possibility that this patch will release on April 1st. All right, they say many bug fixes and improvements with particular focus on the latter sections of the game. Performance improvements for pacing stuttering that was observed during the demo. Camera smoothing, which is, of course, something I just showed you right there. Cutscenes and dialogue frame rate improvements. Freaking awesome. And then, of course, we're going to be getting post-launch follow-up patch and upcoming optimization as well. And we're going to be getting a patch that we'll be releasing soon for controller adjustment options such as dead zone adjustment, acceleration settings, and legacy layouts, loading time improvements for Xbox One and PlayStation consoles, further performance improvements for co-op games, cross-play friends list and invite system across all platforms, and bug fixes and the list will continue to be built on as they progress through launch. So I'm crossing my fingers that this game is an immense success. So far, I'm just having so much freaking fun with the game right now. Now, also some noteworthy stuff found out by the community. Let's take a look right before you guys head into the game. This is a PSA from Elu who says, repeated side quest rewards now have notifications. Like for new loot, curious to find all the differences with the demo. I had to finish one more Terra Captain. Nice. And then this is another cool find from Futz who says this, apparently legendary weapons have a range of stats that can drop at within the same world tier. Cool to know. So it seems like you're never going to essentially get the same legendary weapon. You're going to get different, I guess you would say, roles with that weapon. Don't know how he got so lucky to obtain the sniper rifle here twice, but that is really, really impressive. Now, something really cool for those of you that decided to actually grind the hell out of the demo is that all of your achievements have progressed into the full game, as noted here by Silver Side Down. Demo progress unlocks achievements after just firing up the game right here. So it was really cool when I fired up my game on Xbox, I could see all the achievements going off, and I was like, oh. So that was really, really cool to see, and kind of rewarding. Now, also, I have been playing the game so far and once again really enjoying it. I think they need to fine-tune some of the controls and the cover mechanics further down the road, of course, but my Trickster is really badass. I have two accounts running on PlayStation and of course Xbox, but unfortunately my Xbox one does not have my legendary, but no big deal. I'm sure I'll find one eventually, hopefully soon. Come on, game, give me my legendary. But I've been having fun exploring the world, and yeah, you get this new hub space. I'm not going to spoil anything for you guys when it comes to actual story stuff, but the game is beautiful in this new space. I love the lush green look. There's going to be multiple biomes, but we did get to see right here the option to customize your truck, which is something that we really haven't been able to dive into, and this is going to act like your big show-off big rig, I guess you would say, where you can showcase your trophies and customize your emotes, your banner, and so on and so forth. And you're going to have a lot of unlockables. You can actually customize your front bumper, hood, trailer, rear bumper, wheel, and of course the color of your truck. I'm still undecided. What do I go with? Something that's more on the down low that blends in with the environment, or something that pops? It would make sense to of course go with something that blends in, but hey, we're not gonna do that. I think I ended up going with red. But anyway, yeah, having a total blast with the game. Again, captains seem to be everywhere, and what's really cool about the full game opposed to the demo is that we will be seeing those purple weapon drops. So that's going to be a brand new rarity that's going to be in the rotation of loot, and I think that's going to add a ton of variety to the actual loot system. So I'm excited to get my first purple. Honestly, I haven't played much of the full game. I can't wait to get going and dive into it a lot more here, but I'm going to be bouncing back and forth between my Trickster and my Devastator class, because I've been upgrading those on Xbox at the last second, but I have like four classes all the way upgraded on PlayStation as well, and there is crossplay, so yeah, I hope to play with you all on my Discord, so check out my Discord in the description below. But now it's time to go over your top comments. Remember to leave a comment down below. It could end up in a future video. So let's do this. Let's find out what you guys had to say right now about my previous video, which is, this is fantastic news. They keep improving the game. And then new launch updates. Let's see what you guys had to say about this one. Marcus Powell says, I thought tomorrow was the first. I've never been so hurt. Well, hopefully this video helps some of you guys play the game early. Steven Universe says, did they ever restore loot? Oh, lost accolades because I didn't get crap. I am not too sure. I think they're looking into that system. Jason says, less than 24 hours left. Who else is stoked to play this game? Hell yes. Alvin says, PS5, the counter shows ready to play at noon tomorrow. Bush Wookie says, finally being able to turn off motion blur makes my game run so much smoother, and it makes it look way better. I was so happy they added that option. Jason says, I have not been so anxious to play a game in years. I'll be playing on PS5 tomorrow night. Can't come fast enough. Britt says, man, it's a real shame. I'll be too sick to go to work on the first. A real shame. Yeah, I think a lot of people are going to be calling in sick mysteriously to work. All right, there you have it. The latest about Outriders. I do hope that this video did help you out with getting access to the full game early. Let me know if it pans out for PlayStation users. Again, it seems like you guys won't have to do much if the countdown timer is correct, but it seems like that is going to be the case. Thank you all once again for the love and support on the Outriders videos. Look out for more, and I will see you all next time. Take care.